Hi everyone, Carol here. I want to share a couple of projects with you today that I am entering in Jayzella's Design Team Challenge. If you don't know who Jayzella is, she is Lavish Laces here on YouTube and also has an Etsy shop by the same name. She carries a growing variety of beautiful trims and laces, as well as rosette trims, and she is now starting to stock wild orchid craft flowers. So what I wanted to demonstrate with my projects was creativity, of course, and also show a bit of a range in my style, I guess. So we'll start with this little card that I made for someone as a thank you card. It's one of those corrugated cardboard cards from Michaels. I used the Graphic 45 Secret Garden paper pad, and I have a green cardstock as my first layer back there. Then I distressed the edges of this pattern paper. I added a doily, a paper doily. I cut a butterfly from the paper, from the pattern paper with my Martha Stewart punch. This is also from the paper collection. These are three little rosebuds from Wild Orchid Crafts. This is a Divine Paperline flower by Prima. And this trim here actually is a lace that I purchased from Jayzella. And on the inside, once again, I have a pattern paper, a piece of cardstock, a doily, and another little piece of cardstock where I'm going to put my sentiment. So that's my card. And the little sentiment reads, "And the secret garden bloomed and bloomed, and every morning revealed new miracles." Good. Oh, and this little chip piece is from the Prima Tea Time collection. So that's my first project. Second project I made is one of the origami boxes, and I followed Bonnie, who is Sassy Scrapper here on YouTube, her tutorial. It's the first one that I make, and it was a lot of fun. I'll definitely be making more of these. Again, I used the Secret Garden paper. Over here I have a lilac trim and a small flat back row. And then on the edges here, I used my Martha Stewart punch. Martha Stewart butterfly punches here again. Added a bit of stickles to the center. A little seam binding bow. I added some stickles around the edges there. I don't know if the, you can see a bit of the shine on the edges. And these flowers are from Wild Orchid Crafts as well. We have a two-tone rose here, another rose here. Over here I have a small sweetheart blossom and two orange ones here on top with a small Martha Stewart butterfly once again. And I didn't want to cover the entire top because a beautiful paper is something that should be showcased for sure. And I made the box to mimic what's inside. I made also a first lace roll. So you see the flowers were mimicking the same ones that I had on this lace roll. Butterflies with some little pearls, a couple of bling in the flowers there. And on the outside I used the rosette trim. Jayzella carries tons of the larger rosette trims in her shop. And this is really long because I wanted it to completely fill the thickness of the spool. And so I had to keep going. And what I used were all of my itty bitty little scraps and little doodads that I had hanging around on my desk. I didn't take anything out of my stored items. It was all just bits and pieces. And so as a background, I have a light pink lace. I don't know if that comes through there. Maybe over here. And I have bits of paper from the Prima collections. I have some lace here, pieces of doily, little flowers, resin flowers, little pearls, half of a crocheted flower here, craft flower, paper from the romance collection, another little piece of lace down here. These little flowers are from a lace that I have. A little heart. This is some Webster's Pages trim with a little center that I got from Sock Crafters. A little banner from the Divine collection. Piece of lace, a little wedding applique. Excuse me. Another small applique here. Some beads, a little teeny tiny baby flower, resin flower that I got from Lily. Hi Lily. Here's a piece of a trim, another half crochet rose here, a little piece of lace as a banner with a bow, a little flower that I also got from Lily, and this is a heart bling that I had in my stash, another little tiny applique, some more paper, Prima paper pieces. This is another little flower trim that I had, and I centered it with another little Lily doodad. A nitty bitty cameo. Some pearls. I made a little flower here with some very narrow lace. Another resin flower here with a bling in the center. And then a piece of lace with some pearls and bling. Another piece of paper here. Another teeny tiny little flower from a trim I have with a bling center. Another piece of lace here. Here again, a little crochet flower. I made this one out of a piece of lace that I had, and this is a center from that I purchased from Lily as well. Another tiny little applique, a resin flower here. It's very sparkly. You can see that. A tiny pearl heart. Another piece of paper, Prima paper. I made a rolled rosette out of some trim and centered it with the Aurora Borealis little flowers that Lily sells on her Etsy shop. Piece of trim, another little resin flower that I got from Moloch Crafts, another bling heart, a little bow, pearls here again, and ended it with a piece of doily and a little heart. Yeah, and that's the back of it. This was a lot of fun to make. It reminded me of the crazy quilt tags that we had made for Roxanne's Roxycar 11's challenge, which was also a lot of fun. I love using all my little bits because I save them. Nobody wants to throw all that good stuff away, right? So again, you know, it was very hard to cover the paper because it's so beautiful, and it just fits right into this gummy box. This next piece is very near and dear to my heart. I had found this white plaster frame at a thrift store, and it was white, and it had pressed flowers that were laminated on this side of it. So I stripped it down, I gessoed it, then I painted it with light mocha Americana acrylic paint, and then I used some Tim Holtz distressing inks in Vintage Photo, Brushed Corduroy, Tea Dye, and Gathered Twigs to get the color that I wanted. And what I did is I used a pretty white lace in the background here, white strips, and I glued them down and painted them with that light mocha paint as well. Then I centered my photo and I did the contours with very narrow crochet lace. And these pieces that you see around the frame are all antique trims. But I was fortunate enough to find this trim in particular. I just absolutely love. I immediately knew that I wanted to drape it on the side of this frame. And these little rosettes too, they're so delicate. You can tell they're very, very old. They were made pretty much the same way we make them today, right? Just some lace that was glued in a circle shape and a little applique as the center. Beautiful. And same down here. Now, I had no idea what to use as a center, but then I thought about these clip-on earrings that I had. They're flat pearls, but they're beautiful. I thought they were just perfect because I didn't want to over-adorn it. But yeah, I love this. I really, really love this. I can't wait to display it in my wall unit. I found this while thrifting as well. I paid all of $1 and didn't know if it worked or not. But then, when I tried it, I found out that it does indeed work. Now, I don't know if you'll remember, but it was this ugly yellow color. It was dark, faded ivory color, I guess. What I did, I'll show you the back first. You can see the color there. What I first did was, I just took some pink paint on my finger and I smeared it across just to see if it would look, you know, okay with that color of, with that cream color. What I did is I smeared some pink acrylic paint on it to see if it would look okay with that color. And I kind of liked the look, the effect that it gave when I smeared it on there. So that's what I did to the entire telephone. Oh, blue string. Sorry about that. And when I purchased this, the vision I had was of a bunch of flowers going up on the side like this. And I did the flowers first. What I did is I took a piece of wire and I just wound some seam binding around it to mimic a stem, right? And then I just used some Wild Orchid Craft roses, two-tone rose here. This is a cream rose, gardenia, some little rosebuds. These are from a Prima stem. These are from the Prima engraver, I want to say. I'm not sure, but also from a Prima collection. This was also a Prima flower that I had purchased from Jay Zella quite a while back. She had a de-stash, and I bought some flowers from her. These leaves are from Jay Zella's shop. Like a two-tone yellow and green. This is also from the, I believe, Tea Time collection, a chipboard piece. And again, just some, also have some cherry blossoms, some sweetheart blossoms, some roses. This is a piece of the Prima stem. Yeah, there's a two-tone rose. So yeah, this is the vision that I originally had for the telephone. It was, you know, flowers sweeping up the side. But once I finished it and set it aside and started working just on a foam, I kind of liked it without, I don't know, I just really, really liked it. So what I did, I cut some trim, cut three pieces, and glued it around the dial here. This is from a Graphic 45 Secret Garden as well. It's one of the little stamps, the rose. This butterfly is from the Tea Time collection. I have a couple of roses here, and I have a resin piece here. If you'll remember, this is what they normally look like. And what I did is I used some acrylic paints and I just finger painted it. And I really like the way it turned out. This was a chipboard piece here from the later collections, I believe, the Hello Pastel. I might be wrong. Here's another rose. Over here, I did Prima Satin Pearls. Two different laces here on the headpiece, as well as over here, and then I tied a couple of pieces of seam binding and a couple of different laces onto the end here. And this was also something that Rosella sent me with the flowers that I purchased a long time ago. It was from a 2011 collection, I believe. It was called Le Coq, the Rooster. So, yeah, I thought it was perfect for that. And I just love the look of the receiver when you... And again, I did the same thing throughout. Just, you know, smeared some paint on it. And I just absolutely loved the effect. To hide these ugly screw holes, I glued in a couple of little pearls. And I'd love for you to tell me what you think I should do. Should I permanently affix the flowers to it? Or just leave it without? With? Or without? And if I choose to go without, it is in the shape of a C for Carol, so I probably will use this to make a sign on my my door. But for now, it sits right here. I will post some pictures as well, and there will be, of course, more of them on my blog, which I will list below. So, thank you so much for the opportunity. It's a lot of fun. It gets our creative juices going. And I have really enjoyed watching everybody else's videos. Thanks a lot for watching, guys. Good luck, everyone.